Remember how the Prophet ﷺ was super worried about who? The Christians not accepting? فَلَعَلَّكَ بَاخِعٌ نَفْسَكَ عَلَىٰ أَثَارِهِمْ إِن لَّمْ يُؤْمِنُوا بِهَذَا الْحَدِيثِ أَسَفًا. You need to understand something. Every Prophet has pressure. Every Prophet ﷺ has pressure. Because he knows if the people don't accept, what's going to come? عَذَابَ of Allah. And these are people he loves. If he doesn't love them, he can't be their Prophet. Prophets love their people more than anybody else. Even the kuffar, they love them. Rasulullah ﷺ loves the people that he's giving da'wah to, even if they hate him. He doesn't hate them. He does not hate them. You cannot hate them and care for them and pray for them and make da'wah to them. Da'wah is the ultimate like act of love and concern for someone. So messengers have love for their people. But Rasulullah ﷺ understands that the da'wah he's giving is not just to Quraysh. And if these people don't accept, the consequences are not just limited to them. Because after him, who's not coming? No other messenger. So the pressure is unlike any pressure of any messenger before him. Alayhi salatu wasalam. It's unlike any other. It's not the pressure of one nation falling into misguidance. It is the pressure of all of humanity on all of its continents, of all of its generations falling into misguidance. It is pressure like never, ever, ever before, sallallahu alayhi wasalam. That's enough to want to easily get you to the point where you're going to die out of pressure, out of grief. فَلَعَلَّكَ بَاخِعٌ نَفْسَكَ عَلَىٰ أَثَارِهِمْ. How can they not listen? Don't they realize the consequences of them not listening? On the one hand, this can overwhelm a person, the pressure of they're not listening. By the way, those of some of you that are listening, you're trying to, you know, you feel the pressure to give da'wah to your father, to give da'wah to your mother, to give da'wah to your friend, and they're not listening, and it kills you. It kills you that they're going down the road of disobedience, the road of rebellion against Allah, and it eats away at you. And it can be enough to just kind of just tear you up from the inside. So how is that balanced? On the one hand, you're almost killing yourself in grief. قُلْ الْحَقُّ مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ فَمَنْ شَاءَ فَلْيُؤْمِنْ وَمَنْ شَاءَ فَلْيَكْفُرْ. Tell them the truth is from your Rabb. Whoever wants, they can accept, and whoever wants, they should disbelieve. You have no control. They're going to have to make their decision what? Themselves. You need to internalize this. So Allah doesn't just say Al-Haqqu min Rabbikum. He said Qul Al-Haqqu min Rabbikum. You need to say this to them, because you saying this to them will help you internalize it too. You need to internalize that you're not going to control that.
Download our mobile applications or register on our official website to get access to exclusive content. Links given in description of video.